What storm, Mr. President?
You'll find out.
I've got one that can see.
I want to share this quick 23-second clip. From it's a video and shared. It's from the sheriff, and I want to connect it to a couple things. It has to do with the eclipse.
But that's not all that he's concerned about.
That people want to do us harm. Use an event like this, where a lot of people are gathered, to do some type of terror event.
The director of the Lake County Emergency Management Agency told me they've been preparing for the solar eclipse now for about 2 years.
To do some type of terror event.
The director of the Lake County Emergency Management Agency told me they've been preparing for the solar eclipse now for about 2 years.
Do you hear that? They've been preparing for this for 2 years. A couple other ones I want to connect it to. This is coming out. I think it's like the 14th. It's a few days after the eclipse, and they're really pushing this Civil War movie pretty hard. But check this out, and then I want to show you something else that's in my backyard that's local in Greensboro. It's pretty wild.
Citizens of America.
People of Florida alike.
You gotta move!
And the Western forces of Texas and California. Welcome back to these United States as soon as their illegal secessionist government is deposed.
You don't know what side they're fighting for.
Someone's trying to kill us. We are trying to kill them.
We all know, anybody that has their eyes open, we know that the storm is coming. I mean, ever since 2012, we've known that they're going to crash the dollar. We're going to go to war. We know that the shit's going to hit the fan. I'm not pushing fear, but it's going to happen. See, what they've done to us is they've put us in this slow burn where these people are very, very patient. But I'm just pointing out some pretty odd, you know, coincidences, you know, quote coincidences, that all of this stuff is coming together right around this total eclipse that's going to make an X. But here's the other one that made me think about it. And you guys can pull that trailer up if you want to watch it. But right here.
A migrant site is.
I live in Greensboro, North Carolina, and they're putting all of these up everywhere. It's not just Greensboro, but listen to this.
A migrant site is now operational in Greensboro. We learned today it will still be weeks to months before children start arriving.
We're also learning more details about how the federal facility will operate. WFMY News 2's Amber Lake joins us live now after getting new insight from Greensboro's Congresswoman.
Guys, this site on Hobbs.
Yeah, look at the number of it right over there, 4334. I noticed that earlier.
Road is open and ready for children. I spoke with Representative Kathy Manning earlier today, and she told me that this site here in Greensboro is an overflow facility. That means when some of the similar facilities across the country become full, only then will we see children coming here to Greensboro. Regardless, there are neighbors who live in this area who are weighing it.
Notice they always disguise something nefarious with the children. It's for the children. You know, children are going to be coming here. Why do they need all these facilities and sites to bring all these children in? It's like they're expecting something, but they're not being straightforward and telling us what it is.
And on how they feel about it.
It's been nearly 2 years since we learned the plans for the former American Hebrew Academy.
We have worked hard to make sure that we know exactly what's going on.
Now city leaders say it's operational and ready to. We learned the plans for the former American Hebrew Academy.
We have worked hard to make sure.
Now we know she's a real Hebrew, right?
that we know exactly what's going on.
Now city leaders say it's operational and ready to take in unaccompanied children who
enter
the southern U.S. border without parents or legal guardians. The facility is set up to receive up to 800 boys and girls between 13 and 17 years old.
These kids who are coming here are kids who have been traumatized for the most part. They are kids who've had...
Look at her Star of Rim fam on that little plaque back behind her right shoulder.
A really tough time leaving very difficult situations in their home communities.
Congresswoman Kathy Manning says it's our legal obligation to provide care for these children. The children are referred to the U.S. Office of Refugee Resettlement, or ORR, until they're safely released to a vetted sponsor. Representative Manning says their stay will be around 3 weeks long while this process takes place. We've talked to many neighbors throughout the last 2 years about this facility, which has become a divisive issue among many.
If it's operational, that's nice. Let them come as long as it's a safe place for them.
It's hard for me to understand how something like this could happen and why it's such a big secret. It's been such a big secret since the beginning.
I really do hope that they will be more transparent as time goes on so that it will allay some of our concerns.
Guys, they keep showing that sign back there, 4334. And you know me, I'm not pushing fear. I'm just telling you to be looking up, you know, be ready because it's coming. And I believe that 2024 might be the year.
You think I'm crazy? Huh? Is that what he told you? Well, listen up. There is a storm coming like nothing you have ever seen, and not a one of you is prepared for it.
Closer to the heart.